Embattled Philippine lawmaker Arnolfo Teves Jr. again insisting that the investigation into the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo is unfair. Teves also hits back at Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla, who said that Teves may be designated as a terrorist over his alleged involvement in the assassination.
How can I expect a fair trial kung nakita mo na yung nangyari, di ba? Yung anak ni Boying, di ba? Napawalang sala kagad, sandali lang, ang bilis. Oh. So, kung pwede kang magpawalang sala, pwede ka rin magbigay ng sala.
Teves is talking about Remulla's 38-year-old son Juanito, who was earlier charged of illegally possessing high-grade marijuana worth 1.3 million pesos. A Las Piñas court dropped the wraps against Juanito last January. Teves also asserting he is now subjected to a trial by publicity.
Ang nangyayari kasi ngayon, trial by publicity. Mm-hmm. Sabay, ang daming nililihis na issue-issue. Ito yung gusto ko maintindihan ng taong bayan. Gawin natin simple lang, di ba? Ba't patay ba't nagsisiraan? Bakit, di ba? Kung ano lang yung totoo. Ang mali kasi dito, inuna nila yung suspect bago yung investigasyon. Kaya ngayon, kailangan nilang ipilit na yung investigasyon tumama sa tinuturo nila. Hindi dapat ganun. Mag-imbestiga ka muna bago ka magturo.
Senators continue their probe into a spate of killings in Negros Oriental. Sherian Torres tells us the political clan tagged in the assassination of Governor Roel Degamo is accused of engaging in illegal activities to secure the loyalty of police in the province.
A video of a birthday celebration was played at the hearing of the Senate Committee on Public Order and Dangerous Drugs investigating the unresolved killings in Negros Oriental. It showed provincial policemen celebrating the birthday of Congressman Arnolfo Teves Jr. According to Shaton Mayor Fritz Diaz, cousin of the slain governor, this proves cops are beholden to the lawmaker. Diaz further claims that Teveses are using gambling proceeds to buy their loyalty.
Kaya walang nasold na killings sa Negros Oriental, sir, because of the enforcers. Pero karamihan sa may rank na enforcers, bayad po ng mga Teves using the gambling money.
Pag tinukoy pag Teves, lahat po sila kasi magkakaiba naman po yan.
It's Arnie and Henry, sir.
Diaz adds online cockfighting, which has been declared illegal, is still operating in the province. And police officers who should crack down on this illicit activity are not lifting a finger.
Nung manalo si BBM, sir, stop na lahat. Sila pa rin patuloy. Lantaran. Lantaran, sir. Alam ng lahat. Pero wala silang respeto sa enforcers.
Newly installed Provincial Police Director Alex Gruse Recinto says they have sacked the province's police personnel and they are now undergoing retraining. Degamo's widow, Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo, claims that Teveses are ruling the province with fear and impunity. The mayor also appeals to senators to help them push back, saying victims have nowhere else to go.
We are faced with a giant opponent, moneyed, fueled by East Sabo, fueled by STL, fueled by maybe even illegal drugs. The only place we can go home to po. Hindi namin kayang tumira ng Canada, America, Australia. We only have one beloved Negros Oriental po. Nag-aapila kami. Media, you have a very strong role in preserving democracy in our country. Tulungan niyo kami.
Former Negros Oriental Governor Pride Henry Teves rejects Degamo's claims. The younger Teves insists he is not involved in any illegal activities.
Not involved in any other, in any gaming or numbers games. In fact, I already gave a waiver to my bank secrecy and all my assets. You can check it for the last 15 years.
Other witnesses also testify in Tuesday's hearing. These includes Juanita Generoso, widow of radio broadcaster Dindo Generoso, who was killed in 2019 for commenting about issues on a dump site in Negros Oriental. Juanita claims the killers of Generoso were rewarded by former Governor Henry Teves with contracts and job opportunities. This was denied by Teves.
Para na kasing killing fields to eh. Kung makikinig ka sa radyo, parang walang, mayroong patay, isa, dalawa, the next week, isa, dalawa, nangyayari nang sa Bayawan at Santa Catalina.
A former PNP officer also recounts his experience in Negros Oriental. Former CIDG Director Hansel Marantan, who investigated killings in the province, says he didn't receive any support.
I am also scared up. Takot din ako pumunta doon, but you know, I'm trying to brave myself going there. Yung unang pasok namin dyan, sino ang local policeman na tumulong sa amin? Almost none of you.
In the meantime, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla shot back at Teves, who called the Justice Department's probe a circus. The panel will continue its investigation on Wednesday. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. speaking out against political violence in the country. Marcos orders the National and Regional Peace and Order Councils to root out violent actions targeting politicians. To do that, Marcos suggests increasing visibility of law enforcers in the streets. He also wants the councils to focus on addressing the proliferation of illegal or loose firearms.
There's no other method that I know about that is effective, but for us to be watchful, to conduct continuous drives every so often, mga random drive na maglalagay tayo bigla ng checkpoint at titignan natin basta't walang mga illegal firearms. That is one of the tools that we have to watch out when we are trying to avoid what has been a developing warlordism, I think, at the around the country. But yeah, that's one thing that we can do. Even of the political violence stems from drugs. It stems from the territorial fights over areas where drugs are distributed.
He issued a statement during the first joint National Peace and Order Council and Regional Peace and Order Council meeting in Malacañang.